not a very good day to be going out. It'd have to be 200 metres before you say.
Look at the tummy. Oh.
Any minute now, you'll see him coming around the south end of that fall. There he comes. Bit tumultuous in the bar there, but he's got no problem with the power on that one. Idiot trying their luck. No life jacket. Just going out for a little bit of a trip. Could have been very dangerous. peering into the sunset. A bit more of Brunswick Head. Back to the beach. The old bike. Finish. From a boat coming in safely, I hope. Notorious Brunswick Bar looks safe. If you do the right thing, it is safe. But I run out of tide, it's a big boat. So we'll swing up here as he's coming in, and we'll get a nice little shot of Torokina Beach in a minute. Ah, yeah, you've got plenty of power in that one, buddy. So he's going to stop now and kill the tower, which is just up here, before I have a look though at Torokina. Beautiful little side, little inside reef. Sorry, beach. And up to the seat tower. And that's where it all happens. Slowing him down a bit. Running out tide. Like having a bit of a look. He's just turned around to go back again. I don't think he's gonna. He looks like he wants to go out. He's got his life jacket and all that sort of stuff. But look at the size of the boat. I'll just go around here a bit further and you can just see what he's gonna encounter if he tries to get out of here. There's a lot of broken water. Goes out for about 100 metres. You've got little things like this that can upend him easy. And he's still sitting back in there. And he's still sitting there. He really wants to go. I think he should consider his options. It's a crappy day, and I reckon it's going to rain shortly. I've seen so many people cross this bar, and I've seen quite a few come unstuck as well. Mate, go back home. Oops, I'll just stand up and have a look here. Yeah, it's starting to look alright. And while he's waiting in the river mouth, here comes one of our professional fishermen. Too bad coming in. It's the going out business is the problem. See that little boat in a minute. He's still there. They're not really big. For the size of this large boat, they're big enough to upend him. Sitting there, I think he might be going home. You can have another look, I bet. Yeah, he's turning around to have another go. I'll just switch off for 5 seconds here. He's going to be waiting a while. Still waiting. Oh, it'd be a 15 foot. Got no idea. 14, 15 foot. No, he's turning around again. He really wants to go, doesn't he? I still reckon he should come upstream a little bit and have a bit of an anchor and a bit of a fish and get it out of his system. Because this could be fatal if he's missed times this little exercise. Yep, and he's heading off back home. A wise decision, my son. I mean, it's going to be raining shortly. Although the water's beautiful. Azure, they call that. Not blue, not green. But why go out in the middle of the day? It's a real crappy sea out there. Joggly, windy. What's the point? Anyway. End of the little saga. Bye for now. And the guy waiting, he's had about 3 or 4 goes. Looks like he's committing himself. He's going to have to go if he's going to go now. He's just about committed. way down there is that visitor from New Zealand. You probably just make it out, way down past the surf club. Boat people. Although there was no one on board. They're going to try and salvage that today, I believe. Wouldn't mind being here while they do that. We'll see. So look what this bloke's dragged up. I pan around here. And he's dragged this thing all the way in from New Zealand. You wait, you see it. Oh, there it is. It's a bloody boat. Spruce. Wednesday night she came in through the surf, pushed by the south-easter, and these are the guys that are going to try marine salvage mob. And we've got a photographer, and we've got a lady, no, it's a bloke, and I'll just zoom back. Yeah, so how about that? A couple of my mates have been on board that. They went out to it at midnight on Wednesday night to see if anybody was on board. And there wasn't, thank goodness. Hello, he's going to get a closer look. I'll look too in a minute. But how about it? Scotch bonnet. Long way from Scotland. Long way from anywhere. On Brunswick Heads Beach, would you believe that? We're famous again. So this is the log. They've got heaps of gear coming. Young bloke getting ready. What's he got here? Oh, camera stand. Another one of their trucks. And another view of the Scotch bonnet. What are we going to do with it, they said. Goodness me. Yep. From way, way over there. Land of a long white cloud, all the way to Brunswick Heads. The question is, were they boat people? And where are they now? I've heard they're safe. They got picked up by a helicopter days and days ago. Been really rough terrain. When the boys got on board this, I reckon it was like just about everything was in place. So here's the ship's dog. I know what he's chasing. He's after something. But it's the Scotch bonnet from Sydney.
A couple more pictures for johnfiles.com, eh?
Yeah, for John Fowles' YouTube channel, mate.
Oh, YouTube channel.
Yeah.
I didn't know you had a YouTube channel.
I got a YouTube channel. I got 17 videos on it, and this will be on it this afternoon. Okay, so where was I? I was telling you that it come from way out of there, over there. And there's the break wall. Scotch bonnet. Can't give too much details, but they're going to try and get it off the beach today. Spit of rain, wouldn't that tell you the whole Gaddy United? Pumping out. Just see the head of that bloke. Of course, no mast, they would have been snapped off. Not much action, she's not going nowhere. The old Scotch mist. Nah, not scotch miss. Yeah, scotch bonnet, you idiot. How could you forget that name? One of these locals walking his dogs. This is a dog walking area. People are allowed to come here and exercise their dogs on Brunswick Beach. And I just swing around, a few more people coming up. They're setting up a barrier cordon at the moment, I think. That's how I got here. There's my old bike just over here. Wonder if I can zoom in. Yeah, I pedaled there all the way from way, way up there where I took that first shot. Way up at the brake wall. Not bad for a 73-year-old. She's got a very proud bow on her. Beamy little boat. Trying to think of some cliches. Like, oh, often be gotta. You can sit in my lap and keep on doing. Or, it's a dry brick moon nick your ken. I have to say something Scottish. Like Edinburgh. Glasgow. No more, that's a quality. Silly man. Won't be long before. What was I saying? It won't be long before there's some serious machinery down on the beach. A low loader. 15-20 ton crane. They'll load that on and they'll find somewhere, well, the way they come down along the sand dunes, to take her back out again. There is a road that leads all the way behind the sand dunes, but it'd be so overgrown now it wouldn't be funny. They might have to blaze a trail. I hope Parks and Reserves, the National Parks and Wildlife, can't jump up and down and say, well, you can't take that, it's under legislation. You can't damage any trees. But anyway, I'll work it out. And so we say goodbye to the Brunswick Heads equivalent of the Marie Celeste. I hope she finds a nice mooring with a nice crew and someone looks after her. She's a lovely little boat. I probably won't get back to see it being salvaged, but that's okay. So for the time being, goodbye from Brunswick Head.